1. The Wakefield Asylum was established in 1818. 2. The asylum was home to over 1,000 souls by the mid-1860s. 3. Dr. William Charles Ellis was the asylum's first medical director. 4. James Crichton-Browne became the superintendent in 1866. 5. Patients received personalized treatment plans upon entry. 6. Patients worked in various departments within the asylum. 7. Patients engaged in games, music, and arts for leisure and self-expression.